Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve exercise 3.43 of the textbook, First Course in Probability. So in this problem, we assume that we have three coins. The first one is a two-headed coin. The second one is a fair coin. The third one is a biased coin that comes up heads with probability 3/4. And so the experiment is just select one of the coin at random. We want to find the probability that this was the two-headed coin, given that after we flip the coin, we get heads. So let me write again those information here. So we know that coin one is two-headed, coin two is a fair coin, coin three is going to be a, let me write, 75% heads, a biased coin that will give you heads 75% of the time. You choose one of those three coins at random, and the question is whether you get, let's say, one given coin. In this case, that's going to be coin one. In general, I'm going to call AI the event that coin I is selected. Okay, so the goal here is to compute the probability that we got coin one at the first place, given that after flipping the coin, we see heads. So I can write this here. So that's the goal, is to compute the probability of selecting the first coin according to my event here. That's going to be A1, given that after flipping the coin, we get heads. So given, I'm going to write this event H. Okay, so we are again in some experiment in two steps. Step one, select a coin. Step two, flip a coin. Both steps are random. They are both parts of the experiment. We want to compute the probability of something happening at the first place. That's this event A1, given that we see this at the second step of the experiment. The direction of time here is messed up. We cannot easily compute that in our mind, but clearly the probability of getting heads, given that you chose the two-headed coin, is just equal to one. So this is easier. Clearly, to be able to compute the probability of heads at step two, you need to know which of the three outcomes occur. So what I'm saying here is that in general, P of H given A1 or A2 or A3, those three conditional probabilities are easy to compute. We know also that P of AI, the P of AI are all equal to 1/3, because you choose the coin like at random uniformly. So each coin is equally likely to be selected. So all this motivates, again, the use of Bayes formula. You want to use Bayes formula here to be able to re-express P of A1 given H using P of H given AI in general. And so the partition we are going to use in this case, it's clearly A1, A2, A3. It's clear that one of the three should occur at step one, and exactly one. So that means that indeed A1, A2, A3 is a partition of the sample space that gives you information about what happens at the first step. Given this information, you are able to compute the probability of heads. Okay? So all this was to motivate the use of Bayes formula. So now, I'm going to say that we use a Bayes formula, but using the partition. So we said A1, A2, A3. That's our three events, A1, A2, A3. Then if we do this, then we can rewrite this as, so we said P of, I'm going to write the definition, so A1 intersection H divided by P of H. And again, the idea here of the conditioning on the partition is to conclude this one, you said that probability of having heads is probability of having heads given that I'm using coin 1, 2, or 3 times the probability of using coin 1, 2, or 3. So that's going to be equal eventually to this one can be written as P of H given that we use coin 1 times P of A1. And then you have to divide. So this P of H, what I'm doing here is like kind of way proving quickly base formula. So P of H is going to be the sum for I equals 1 up to 3 of P of H given AI times P of AI. Okay, so now this one wasn't natural to compute, but all those probabilities or conditional probabilities are extremely easy to compute. You see first that because you choose a coin at random, so each of them with the same probability 1/3, that means that P of A1 is 1/3, for all I, P of AI is 1/3, so you have a simplification, you can just simplify by 1/3 top and bottom, and then you just have to compute those conditional probabilities. Now, if you choose coin 1, A1, given A1, you use coin 1, you get obviously heads with probability 1. So this conditional probability here is just 1. So you start with A1, divided by the first term here is the same, it's A1 again. Then the second term is P of H given A2. Probability of having heads if we use the fair coin, well, that's just going to be 1/2. Okay, and then plus probability P of H given A3, probability of getting heads if we use this third coin, that gives you a 0.75, that's a 3/4. And that gives you our probability. So now you can simplify this. You multiply, let's say, by 4, top and bottom, you get 4 divided by 4 plus 2 plus 3, 4 plus 2 plus 3, that gives you a 9. So conclusion, the probability that we use, the probability that we use, given that we see heads, the probability that coin 1 was chosen is 4/9. You see that it's larger than 3/9. 3/9 is 1/3. That would be the probability of choosing coin 1 with no extra information. It's just 1/3. Obviously, given that you observe heads, that should increase the probability that coin 1 was chosen. And indeed, this conditional probability is equal to 4/9, which is strictly larger than 1/3.